Taking a closer look at each layer, we find different snow crystals. Snow crystals evolve over time. By looking at them, we can put together the story of the winter. Some crystal types include rounds, facets, surface hoar, stellars, and graupel. It hasn't snowed here in a week. The crystals in this top layer, over here, have changed since they fell. These are decomposing fragments. They are bits and pieces of original snowflakes. Lower in the snowpack, over here, the crystals are small and densely packed. Let's have a look. These are forming strong bonds called rounded grains. If we look even lower, we can see a harder layer, and that is a sun crust formed earlier in the winter.
It may surprise you to learn that the temperature of the snow changes from the surface to the ground. The cool thing about these temperatures is that they're always close to 0 degrees Celsius at the ground, even if the air temperature is minus 20. Temperatures are important because they influence how snow crystals change with time. Large temperature differences tend to weaken the snowpack. We measure the temperature every 10 centimeters. So 20 is minus 3, 40 is minus 0.3, sorry, minus 0.3, 30 is minus 0.3, 40 is minus 0.3, 50 is minus 0.3, 60 is minus 0.3. In this spring snowpack, there is not much change in the temperature. We've added these circles today to make it easier to see the different temperatures at different points in the snowpack.
Now, these videos are not meant as avalanche training. Get more information about avalanche safety training at the following links.